to the Celebrity Movie Trivia Schmoedown. I'm Christian Harloff.
And I am Clark Wolf. It's so good to see you guys, and boy, do we have a fun show today.
I know you're super excited. I'm excited, too. Look, the cast from It is here. I mean, you got to be kidding me. This movie, first of all, I remember when the miniseries came out back in the day. Yep. I loved it. And then they said they were going to do a film. And then you start putting together some of this young up-and-coming talent that is just crushing it lately. And I'm on board. I've been scared. I have been ready. I've been excited. And now we get the Losers Club here. They might be strung together, but they're going to be united today, divided today, because it is free-for-all style, Clark.
Man, we are going to break them up like Pennywise and Kneebolt Street. So the plan for today is we are going to ask these kids a bunch of fun questions and see who is going to take the win.
Yeah, and if you guys are familiar with the Schmoedown free-for-all style, we have a bunch of different competitors that are coming out. They will be on the table. They will be answering questions, but they will be elimination style. So this will be a little different how we do it. There'll be seven competitors, all from the Losers Club, and they will be going head-to-head. Three questions in the first round. They will be writing down their questions on the board. If they are tied by the end of round one, then another competitor will come out, and then there'll be three on the table, then four, and so on and so on. However, if they do not have enough points by the end of the round, they will be eliminated until there is one person standing. Clark, are you ready to get going?
I'm ready, Christian. Let's do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Movie Trivia Schmoedown! Celebrity Schmoedown, free-for-all style. All right, introducing first, representing the Losers Club, making his Schmoedown debut, Little Star-Lord, Wyatt Oleff! There he is! There he is! He's come out, he's excited, he's taking a seat, he's ready to go.
Oh my God, ready to rock.
And coming out next, also representing the Losers Club, the Jack of All Trades, Jack!
Helium! Fast out here! Helium now.
All right. Okay, guys.
Woo, get lightheaded.
Jack, Wyatt, how you guys doing?
Great.
Pretty good.
You guys ready?
All right. Thank you.
Let's get ready to Schmoedown! Here we go. Round number one underway. Here we go, guys. Your first question. What's the name of the First Order's follow-up to the Death Star in Star Wars The Force Awakens? What is the base called?
This is a tough one.
It is.
I don't even know this one.
You didn't know this one?
No.
This one is that you have to see Force Awakens a few different times.
I kind of forgot it.
That's all right. Guessing is acceptable.
Yeah, guessing is good.
And five, four, three, two, one, and Wyatt.
Death Killer Base.
Close.
Oh. No idea.
All right, no points there yet, but they still survive here. All right, here is the next one.
That's close.
Oh. Which character has the ability to shine in 1980s The Shining? Which character had the ability to shine? Another one.
This is a good one too.
That's a tougher one.
Yeah
these are questions here cutting deep, but in the world of horror. All right,
okay.
Here we go. And five, four, three, two, one, pens down, and Jack.
I can't remember his first name, but I know his last name's Torrance.
Okay.
We might take Torrance.
I forgot.
All right. I'm going to give Jack the point there. So 1 point there.
Good
Jack's going to have
Jack.
The point. 1-0. 1.0. Okay, so
good
here's
job.
Your final question. So here is how it's going to work here. Wyatt needs to get 1 point here, and Jack needs to miss, or Wyatt will be eliminated, and we'll get our next competitor. All right, question three. All right. What villain do the Avengers fight at the beginning of the movie Captain America Civil War?
God.
Captain America Civil War. So right now, Jack and Wyatt are battling out. All right.
It's a civil war between the losers.
It seems like it right now. And if Wyatt misses, he will be eliminated here. And five.
No.
Four. three. Two, one, hands down, please. Let's start with Wyatt.
I tried to write some guy's base, but it just says some gooch.
Some gooch is not correct.
Close.
Jack.
I don't know. I said all I said was Agent Civil Badman.
It doesn't matter. Infantry Lemon wins it up because 1-0 with that. Wyatt has been eliminated.
I don't know geek stuff.
All right, so we're going to have Wyatt leave the table as we get our next competitor out here. All right, introducing next, representing the Losers Club, the Chosen One.
Oh.
Chosen!
Chosen is ready.
He's got purpose here.
He is ready to go.
Have gloves, let's go.
Sharp.
All right, same thing. So Chosen, here we go. So are you familiar with the rules right now? You got to write. We'll ask you the question. You will write it. When it's your time to reveal it, you show it to the camera. Worth 1 point apiece. You ready to go? All right, here we go. All right, Clark.
All right. What is the name of the iconic dance Chunk does at the beginning of The Goonies?
Oh, man.
Stop. Oh, gosh.
Oh, my God.
The Goonies is one of my faves.
I don't know this. All time. Yeah, so right now it is.
The kid that plays Chunk, did you know, is now a lawyer.
Hey,
he's a
very successful Jack.
Yes. I know it. Don't tell me. Please don't say a word.
Okay.
Four.
I don't know this.
Three. At 2-1, Chosen, y'all got it?
I guess something.
What'd you guess?
I said mashed potatoes.
Oh, so close!
And
so
Jack.
Close.
Jack.
Shuffle.
Does it say shuffle?
He got it. Okay, Jack got it.
You're good opponent.
Good job.
1-0. Jack gets it. So Chosen needs to catch up here as Jack takes the lead here. 1-0.
All right, here we go. In what Jack Black movie does he play the author of a popular kids' book series?
And a recent movie.
Very recent movie. Popular kids' books out in the 90s. These children were probably not born.
Probably not. Don't make me feel older than I am.
Yes, well, if you feel older, I feel old.
Better. Five, four,
I feel like Jeremy would know this one.
2-1, pens down, and Jack.
I know this isn't right. It's School of Rock.
So close.
I guess Goosebumps.
That's correct.
Chosen ties it up.
There you go. Chosen ties it up
with 1-1.
All right.
So here's how it works. Next question here.
Mama, I love you.
If Chosen and Jack both stay tied, then we will bring one more competitor out onto the table right now. All right, here we go.
All right, here we go, guys.
Oh, come on.
What Batman comic book villain is played by Cillian Murphy in Batman Begins?
Batman Begins.
Jack.
My favorite of the Dark Knight trilogy, by the way.
I'm not sure about the guy's name, but I'm just guessing.
It's Ultron.
That's okay. You can guess.
It's Ultron.
Guessing's good.
Here we go. Five, four, three, two, one. Chosen?
Scarecrow?
That's correct, Jack.
He got it.
Yes.
Jack?
Scarecrow.
No, what do you have?
I said the Riddler.
Oh, with that, Jack has been eliminated.
Jack,
Chosen stays on the table.
But it was close.
It was close. What a battle here with the Losers Club having a lot of fun. But Jack has now been eliminated. All right. All right, so our next competitor introducing next. Representing the Losers Club, he is Big Bill, Jaeden Lieberher! With the balloon himself.
He's so lost it.
Oh, the drop flips and go.
Oh my gosh, it looks like we had a party.
Yeah, we're a big fan.
Oh shoot.
I'm a big fan here.
Okay, here we go. This is a lot of fun as we get to our next question here, guys. Okay, ready? Chosen, Jaeden, you guys ready to go?
Yes.
All right, here we go. Next question.
Where do we look?
In Stand By Me, Gordy, Chris, Teddy, and Vern journey into the woods looking for what? What are those kids looking for?
What are they looking for?
Chosen, come on.
Stand By Me, another Stephen King adaptation.
It is a Stephen King
adaptation, I'd say, along with this version of it, probably two of the best Stephen King adaptations.
How could Shawshank also?
Okay.
Of course, I would have gotten this too.
Four, three, two, one. Chosen.
I said their friend.
Their friend. Okay,
what do you got, buddy?
Dead body.
That's correct. Jaeden gets 1 point. Jaeden gets 1 point. These kids are really doing one up. All right, here we go. Next question.
You're coming for me.
I know, right?
What planet do the Na'vi inhabit in Avatar? What planet?
Oh, my gosh.
What planet?
Oh, my gosh. What is that called?
Trying to think here.
What?
Chosen trying to get the.
Gosh, Lee. I know this too.
This is a
big blue planet.
Yeah,
big
one.
No cheating by the rest of the Losers Club on the couch.
Great.
And
I'm trying to make phone a friend.
Five, four, three, two, one. Pens down. And Jaeden, what do you got?
Blue Planet.
Close.
Is it like Naui something?
Looking for Pandora.
Pandora.
Oh, that makes sense.
Pandora, the music. Okay.
All right, question exactly. Question number three here. Question number three. So Chosen now needs to get this, and Jaeden needs to miss, or Chosen will be eliminated. Here we go. What actress stars as the voice as Fiona in the Shrek movies?
Got him.
Jaeden, oh my gosh. Smack as we get into it here.
All the Shrek movies.
Yep.
Oh my gosh. What is, I don't know.
And
I don't
know. It's okay if you don't spell her name. Spelling
okay.
Doesn't count.
Five. Four. Three. Two. One. And Chosen.
Melissa.
And Jaeden.
Cameron
Diaz is correct. Jaeden, 2 points. And with that, Chosen has been eliminated. All right.
Great job, Chosen.
So with that, okay, so I like these kids are going back and forth, back and forth. I'm loving it. All right. Their next opponent representing the Losers Club, he is the Lone Wolf, Finn Wolfhard.
Ready to rock.
I'm picking this kid so far,
man. I think this is going to be a tough round.
Yeah. All right. Here we go.
Here we go, guys. How many members of the Guardians of the Galaxy are there by the end of the first movie?
You know the answer.
I do know the answer to this, Schmoedown viewers. I sure do. I missed this infamous question. A similar version.
You kind of did, but not really.
I mean, not really.
We had
but
to change the rule.
It was you did. One round too late. You changed that rule.
Five, four, three, two, one. Pens down, please. And Finn, you don't have to write all their names. Just how many?
Okay. Five.
That's correct.
Five.
That's
nice
correct.
Job.
Finn
nice
and
job.
Jaeden, 1-1 here. All right. Next question.
All right.
Good boy.
I love
you
it.
You wrote them all down. Why?
Yeah, because I couldn't think.
Okay, here we go. What sport does Riley love to play in the 2015 Pixar movie Inside Out? What sport does Riley like to play?
Soccer.
Five, four,
football.
Three,
soccer.
Two, one. Pens down, Jaeden. Both have hockey. All
hockey.
Right, 2-2. 2-2. So
tied.
Once again, here's how it works. So now, if they stay tied, we will bring in one more competitor to be at the table, unless one misses and one gets it correct.
One may win, one not.
One schmo lose.
That's right.
That's right.
All right, here we go. Who did Christian Bale play in 2009's Terminator Salvation?
You're
what character
you got this,
Finn's been perfect so
did
far.
Christian Bale
don't do that.
Play
it's offensive.
In 2009's Terminator Salvation?
He's asking Finn for the answer.
Played him again, Arnold. Finn. They're showing a laugh. Here we go. He's pointing towards the sky again.
Uh-oh. Five.
He thinks he can get the wise guy out of the bath.
Four.
Hey, Jack.
Be a close one.
Don't talk to me.
Three.
It seems as is.
Two.
I'm not here.
One. And Finn?
John Connor.
That's
John
correct. Connor, and Jaeden.
And he gets the
And
Jaeden makes a big dip in the son of
hell. Battle there.
That was
a battle there, but Finn's in. But again,
now
the
Bruce
club.
Is dead, and
okay.
Jaden is dog.
All right, so.
Dog on.
Okay, here we go. Introducing next, representing the Losers Club, making her Schmoedown debut, Sophia Lights Out! Yeah! There she is.
She entered the ring. Passionate smile.
All right. Okay.
I love it.
All right, guys. So same thing here. We are going to have three questions for you guys, and we're going to start here with first question. What kind of animal does the T-Rex eat before breaking out of his cage in Jurassic Park?
Ooh.
What kind of animal?
This is a tough
there
one.
There are many animals one. In this country, but which one
this
will
is
it
a
be?
Tough one for people that are not 10 years old.
Well, I mean,
could be a coyote.
You just gotta think
could
about
be a puma.
That.
Yeah.
It could be.
And what would a T-Rex want to eat?
Everything.
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 Yeah, probably.
All right.
Lawyers.
Yep. Five.
He does. I know.
Four.
They are
wolf.
Delicious.
A hard wolf.
Three. Two.
I think they're collaborating.
One. That's okay. One. Pens down. And Finn.
I didn't know what I said. A cow.
That's incorrect.
So
Sophia.
Close. I wrote nothing.
That's okay. Right.
That's okay. You guys are still tied.
What was it?
Goat. Goat.
Goat.
Goat. Goat was the answer.
Oh.
Goat. Goat. Okay.
That was okay. That All right. was good job.
Here we go. All right. What kind of animal are Scar's henchmen in the Disney classic The Lion King?
Ooh, that's a good question. lots of animal questions.
A lot of animal Finn questions round. Right now, right now. So
this round not
Finn,
brought to you by PETA.
Finn no, no, does not, a little bounce in his chair. No. He waves to someone in the
friends.
Audience. We do not
Except
know who.
Except for when the goat got eaten.
He shows an enthusiastic smile to this person.
Five.
You're making eye contact with me. I
four,
know who you're talking to.
I don't know what he's talking about.
Three, two, one. It's Sophia.
Hyena.
Yes!
That's correct.
I got a hyena too.
Oh, they're tied up there. 1-1. 1-1. All right.
And Pizza and Cream is all they shared tonight.
Final question in this round here. Okay, here we go. All right, so Sylvester Stallone reprised his role as Rocky in the movie Creed. Who played Adonis in that movie?
Ooh.
Nope.
I like the honesty here.
Yeah,
I like the honesty.
Come on.
And
yeah. Well.
Five.
His heart is
four. Three. Two. One. Pens down. Oh. Finn.
I know it starts with Michael. I don't know his last.
Yes.
name.
And Sophia.
I
wrote nope.
Well, it's 1-1, so that means one more person will be coming out here.
Right.
So both Finn and Sophia will stay on the table.
Oh. Is it Michael?
Michael B. Jordan was the answer. Michael B. Jordan. So our last competitor will come out, and we will have three competitors on the table, five questions in the final round here. And here we go. And now introducing our final contestant representing the Losers Club, Jeremy the Ray Gun, Ray Taylor!
Yeah! And I hear Jeremy's never seen an episode of Seinfeld in his life.
We got three of the Losers Club left ready to go. So five questions here in this round. Whoever scores the most out of the five will be our champion today. All right, are you guys ready to go?
Sure. Yes.
All right, here we go.
Rock and roll.
Clark.
Here we go. Who directed 2013's Mama? We thought we might have a trick question in our hands. However, perhaps we were wrong.
Maybe we didn't. We'll find out. And
Giovanni Ribisi.
Five. We wouldn't be able to air this question.
Mark Twain.
Four.
My handwriting.
They will not be back for this.
Three.
Quentin Tarantino.
Two. One. Finn.
Andreas Muschietti.
Oh, perfect. Nailed it.
Sophia.
What he said.
Okay.
And great.
Okay. Sorry. And Jeremy.
Excuse my handwriting. It's very, very bad.
It's great. What do you got there?
And he's disqualified for his handwriting.
He's got it. He's got it. All right.
Good job, guys.
One.
Be right back.
Okay, so all tied up. All right. Here we go. In Star Wars Return of the Jedi, what creatures call the planet Endor home? What are the creatures called who live on the planet Endor? And five, four, three, two, one. Pens out, Sophia.
No.
Jeremy.
I don't know.
All right, Finn.
I said sand people, and I know it's not that.
All right, we're looking for Ewoks. Ewoks.
Wait.
On Endor.
I thought the Kashyyyk. What did I think of Kashyyyk? Oh, because of Wookiees.
Close.
I was.
All right.
I was thinking a totally wrong place.
Question.
I don't know.
I'm sad of myself.
Three.
Yeah. Okay, here we go. The same person directed all three Lord of the Rings movies and all three Hobbit movies. Who is that person?
George
Lucas.
Yeah.
John Turturro.
Five. Four.
I don't know his last name.
Three, two, one. Jeremy.
I only know his first name.
What'd you write?
Peter.
All right.
I might give you half a point. Finn.
Peter Jackson.
That's correct. Sophia.
Picture of herself.
It looks like it looks like Peter Jackson. Okay, so if Finn hits this next point, he will win the game. If Sophia and Jeremy cannot get the points, all right, here we go. Next question.
Let's do this, Sophia.
All right, Steve Carell voices two characters in the latest Despicable Me movie.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
What are their names?
Wait, I don't know the second one's
Hogan.
Name.
Hogan. He voices Hulk Hogan.
Yeah. And
Hulk Hogan and Andreas.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1 All right, Finn.
Gru and Kid Gru.
Oh.
I don't know.
No, that's Sophia.
Gru and Gru's twin.
And Jeremy.
Nope, that's incorrect.
It's just Gru. I don't know. I don't know.
I think we'll give the twin. We're gonna give Sophia the twin there. So 2-2 Finn, Sophia. 2-2
There's a twin.
Yeah. Gru and Drew.
Gru
and Drew. So the twin. We're gonna take twin. All right. So. Now we have, this is our final question here. Finn and Sophia, then if Jeremy hits this and Sophia and Finn miss, then Jeremy's still in it. However, if Finn or Sophia both get three here, we could go into a sudden death. All right, last question here, Clark.
Here we go. Okay. Jeez Louise. What Leonardo DiCaprio film is this a quote from? No idea is simple when you have to plant it in someone else's mind.
Great movie. Great movie.
All right, so here we go.
How do you guys know? I don't. No.
Maybe. Yes.
Sophia.
Guess a Leo movie. Guess a Leonardo DiCaprio movie.
You can guess one.
Think about the clues.
Just guess it.
Five.
No, I don't. Okay. I've read. I did nothing.
Four. Three.
Shutter Island.
Two. One. Jeremy, what do you got?
Inception.
That's correct.
Woo! I also got Inception.
Sophia.
Bye.
And your winner with 3 points.
Oh.
Wins it. But what a battle there, Sophia. So Finn, you want to go ahead and grab the championship there if you want. So Finn is the champion of the Losers Club. He's got it. What a match here, Clark. That was a lot of fun. A lot of movie knowledge there.
Oh my gosh, I was so impressed. They got so many great ones.
Yeah, I was impressed also. It was a lot of fun. I liked it really the way that they all kind of played together. They had some fun. They threw some jokes in there. Sophia was a great sport about it. So I'm excited to hear from all these guys. And we got Perry Nemiroff, who is backstage right now talking to all the Losers Club. Let's talk to Perry.
Hi guys, this isn't awkward, but I want to know, you survived your first Schmoedown. Is it what you thought it was going to be, or was that way more intimidating?
I thought I would go head to head against the Finn Wolfhard. I didn't make it that far.
I thought I wouldn't be as disappointed in myself.
I agree with Jeremy here. I should have gotten those questions.
I was very pleased with myself. I'm just kidding. I lost.
I think you did pretty well. So if we had made bets at the beginning of this, would you guys all have thought that Finn would have won?
I thought Jack would have won.
I thought Jack or Jake.
I don't know geek stuff. I don't know like certain sci-fi, like what was the Star Trek man and Sandman.
What's your specialty?
Like classic 80s, 70s, 60s movies.
Like Star Wars.
What
movie starred Jack Nicholson in 1958?
Who was something about Cuckoo's Nest?
A sun flew over the cuckoo's
Something
nest.
About the cuckoo's nest.
It still counts. All right, let's talk a little bit about making this movie here. I remember when we were on Collider Nightmares and we saw the very first image of Bill as Pennywise. Do you guys remember the first time you saw him in costume on set?
Yeah. Ooh. Very thoroughly.
Yeah. Jack had the honor of seeing him first.
Yes, I did indeed.
What was your reaction? Is it as scary as it is on screen in person?
Yeah, I think it is. I was a trip. It was amazing seeing what he turned out to be.
Yeah. Finn and I had to rush in and save him when he was about to be eaten by Pennywise.
That is true.
It's terrifying because when he whipped his head around and stared at us, first time we ever got to see him.
So sometimes when you're making a horror movie, something might not look very scary on set, or it might even look silly. And then when you see it in the final cut of the film, then it's really scary. Is there anything that you guys saw while you were shooting that you're like, that's never going to work?
Jeremy.
Just in general, Jeremy.
For me.
Yeah.
I know. There was something there that we had to shoot in the garage. I'm not going to give too much away, but there was something we had to shoot in the garage, and one of the grips had to hold up this big Pennywise head. It's like, hey, he's coming at you. And we're like, ah! We directed like him, his big cutout head.
It's really embarrassing.
Yeah.
The coolest thing about Pennywise as a villain is, yeah, he's a creepy clown, but he's so much more than that because he reflects what you are most scared of. So if you guys encountered Pennywise in real life as yourselves, what would he turn into?
He would turn into a tiny box and I'd be in it. I'm claustrophobic.
He's claustrophobic, apparently. For me, he would put me in a tarp and put me in water, and you'd be drowning me slash suffocating me at the same time.
All these kids are very mentally scarred.
That's what he would be.
For me, I think he'd stab me and then a bunch of ants would do their thing. Like that.
That's the situation.
That the animals just do what they want to do.
You remember that one scene in Indiana Jones?
Yeah.
The crystal skull one?
I think mine would be a pigeon that is possessed by the devil.
Oh.
Or the devil holding an angry pigeon.
Clearly, you guys should be writing the
pigeon.
Sequel.
A pigeon.
Walter Pridgett. Who's that again? Is that a person?
Mine would be maybe a giant rat. That'd be crazy. Maybe a giant rat or like or a pack of coyotes or something. That'd be Weird Al.
Sophia, Chosen, what do you got?
Mine's pretty practical, like going blind or going deaf. That'd be horrible. Yeah.
All of those sound terrifying. I'm trying to think. I would think, I was going to say a giant spider, but that happened in the original hit, so that's not really...
Still counts.
Original, but that's what scared me. That's what it is.
Well, thank you guys for sharing your personal nightmares. Thank you for, seriously, thank you guys for crushing this adaptation. You guys are fantastic. Finn, our new movie trivia Schmoedown champ here for It. Thank you guys so much for coming out.
All right, Clark, so there you go. I mean, obviously they had a lot of fun doing it. It was good to hear Finn. The dynamic is really there with all these guys, and that's what I thought was a lot of fun.
They are absolutely friends on camera and off, and it just goes to show how good their chemistry was in the movie. I can't wait for everybody to see it.
All right, guys, so make sure you check out It. That's right, It comes out. Clark, hit me. When's it come out?
September 8th, and I don't even have that in my notes.
I know you don't.
It.
I know you do. September 8th, It comes out. Make sure you check it out. Stephen King's adaptation, it comes to screen. Make sure you check out everybody you've seen today here in the Losers Club.
Float too.
Pennywise, you will float too. And we're going to float too right out of the studio. And we'll see you guys next week for the Movie Trivia Schmoedown.